Hi, subscribers and viewers. Welcome back to this wonderful channel, OWUUBII channel. So in this video, I'm going to show you a practical way of how you can turn mikrotik router into an intrusion detection system. Yeah, so in a couple of days ago, I noticed unusual activity happening on my network. What I noticed was various public IPs from various regions of this world trying to gain access into my network. And mind you, so far as your network is being introduced to a public network, you might be vulnerable to attacks. And so, for you to be safe on your network, you need to actually initiate security measures that will prevent such intrusions. One will ask, how did you know about this activity? It's simple. As an engineer, for you to understand your system very well and have a real-time monitoring, you need to always get to your logs, and then you can seek any information you need from your device in real time. So in mikrotik, it has the log part of the operating system, of which you can see in real time the activities happening on your network. Okay, so my log was able to tell me these IPs are trying to gain access to your network through this protocol. And upon further investigation, from my firewall and the connections, I could see the source of the IP and the port it's using and the destination of the IP and the port it's using. I went further ahead to search it online, as in investigate that particular IP. So I was able to get the history of the IP, the spam history of it, the abuse history of the IP, the location of the IP, and even the address of that particular IP. Okay, I was able to gain all this information, and then someone will further go and ask a question: what did you do after gaining all this information? After gaining all this necessary and vital information, it actually helped me to initiate a firewall rule that will block this entire network, because of course that IP belonged to a network. So I blocked the entire network and went ahead and blocked its various ports that will in the future will try to use and come into my network as an intruder. I could have decided to block that particular port, but since I knew what I was doing, I blocked every port that will come from that particular network. Okay, and after doing that, when you go back to your firewall under the rules you've created against that network, if they are trying to gain back into your network, you will see the statistics going on. You'll see a traffic kind of trying to get access into your network, and there you realize that okay, this IP is trying to actually get access into my network. And so these are some of the security measures you can actually put in place in mikrotik, and which is going to serve as an intrusion detection system. Okay, and so if you have a monitor somewhere in your office or in your room or anywhere, you can just open your logs on that particular monitor and you can have a real-time view of what is happening in your network. Okay, kindly stay tuned, relax, watch whilst I bring you a practical situation on this this particular scenario. Thank you. So let's begin with the very first step. So I told you, I noticed this activity was going on in my router when I went to my logs. Okay, so example, I see this rogue IP here. You double click and open it, and it's able to tell you the state of this IP, which is established. So I need to further copy this IP and confirm it from my firewall connections. Okay, by finding it here. If it's able to find it, it's going to display here somewhere. Okay, so example, let me take this let me try this IP. Okay, good. So if you paste the IP here and it's located and you double click it, it's going to tell you the source of the IP. This is the source IP example. This is the port it's using. This is the destination IP. This is the port it's using. Okay, the reply address and then the destination address all comes with ports, and then this is the protocol it is using, right? And the state of it established. If you go further, you'll be able to see the statistics of that particular IP which is trying to connect to your network. When you are done here, the next thing I need to do is to go online and search for this particular IP. And there are so many websites you can actually search an IP from. And this is the one I mostly use, which is cleantalk.org. It gives you a vivid history of that particular IP. So you go ahead and find it. Okay, so it says spam activities not found in any records. If you scroll down, you'll be able to see the source or the country of it. I know that sometimes folks uses VPN services, proxy services, for them to assume that they are in a particular country. So I wouldn't be surprised if someone is in, let's say, in the US and using a VPN that says that he's in China. Okay, I understand that. But this is able to tell you the name of the organization, right? The website, okay? It's able to tell you the hosted website, okay? So if you further click it, click show hosted site, it will navigate to this part. But of course, if it doesn't have so much information on this IP, you are not going to see details of it on this website. Okay, if we go down to spam and brute force activity on date, this is where you can be able to see some details with regards to activities of this particular IP. Now let's search for one that comes up with all these activities. Example, this is an IP. Okay, so let me use this as an example. This is the detail of this IP which is trying to get access into my network. This is the network of the IP address. This is the parent network. This is the organization, the country of origin. This is the address the telephone number, the website. It goes on and on and on. If we come to the spam and brute force activity on date, it is able to tell you some detail. Okay, but in this case, nothing has really happened. Right? So, basically, just to make you understand how this thing works. Normally, if you come to the spam and brute force activity on date, it is able to tell you details of the activity of this IP online with regards to spam and brute force activities. Okay, and so when you're able to get this information about this IP, let me go back. Okay, so this is it. All I need to do is to just copy this IP, this entire network, get into my router, initiate a firewall rule. So this is my firewall rule output. I don't want anything going out from my router to any intruder. Okay, so this is the network. Now this is the protocol you would normally specify. Okay, but in this case I want it in a situation that any protocol, any port number that comes from this network should not be accepted in my network. Okay, so we just leave them at blank, but just put in the destination network and navigate to action, and then you drop. Probably you can decide to give it a comment that drop this IP. Then you apply and then bring it up as a first priority. Okay, and then basically if there is any IP from this network which is trying to intrude into your network, you will see a certain statistics going on at your right side here. So examples, these are certain rogue IPs. I've actually disabled them from getting access into my network. So as you can see, like this IP, there is an activity going on here which is trying to gain access into my network, but because of the firewall rule I've initiated, it's finding it difficult to gain access into my network. Okay, furthermore, if you want to protect your router and then find vulnerabilities with regards to your network, simply initiate or launch what is called the Nmap. It's an open source software called Nmap. You actually use this Nmap to search for vulnerabilities in your network. So example, this is my network. Let me search for vulnerabilities in my network. It is able to give you detail scan about your network with regards to open ports and closed ports. And these are the various means by which intruders or hackers are able to gain access into your network. So always make sure your network is protected, the devices on your network are protected, your servers, your NAS and other devices on your network are always protected. Because if your network is open and is less protected and an intruder is able to get into your network, you are doomed. Right? The person will be able to have all or any access to your files, your folders, any important vital information will be sent out to this intruder. So always make sure your network is protected. Okay, so as you can watch on the screen, the Nmap is still scanning and it's a very deep scan. Okay, in some few minutes it's going to give me details of all my ports. Okay, so let's wait a while and see what happens. So these are all firewall rules created, which is simply to disable any intruder from getting access into my network. Okay. You guys go ahead and configure a firewall rule to stop all public IPs trying to gain access into your network, but only a public IP coming from your device. And so you should know and understand exactly what you have, the kind of firewall rule you will try to initiate in this essence, else you will end up blocking yourself from gaining access into your network. Okay, right, so this is a deep scan of, let's say this is my network, right? So Nmap scan report for this host is down. Okay, it goes all the way and tells you 64 hosts, 1000 ports or hosts, discovered open ports. So these are the number of open ports that has been discovered on this IP or on this network. Okay, it is still discovering open ports. So if you initiate a scan like this, you'll be able to understand which ports are vulnerable on your network and which must be blocked or allowed. Okay, so this tool, which is called Nmap, also helps you in checking the vulnerabilities of your network and initiate a good security measures to protect you from hackers and intrusions. All right, folks, thank you for watching this video again. I understand clearly that you now know how to turn your mikrotik router to an intrusion detection system. Okay, just make sure your network is protected, because so far as you're on the internet, which is a public space, you might be vulnerable to attacks. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel, watch my videos, don't forget to like my videos, and your comments are expected as well. Thank you.